Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 2441, list all lottery combinations. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today, a question sent in by Reid wants to find all combinations of six numbers from 1 to 44. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, all the way on up to 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. Obviously a lottery question. The first thing we have to be aware of is there's a lot of them, right? That's why it's so hard to win the lottery. If you have 44 numbers chosen six at a time, that is 7,059,052, right? So you wanna get a list of 7 million items. You know, the first problem is we don't have that many rows in Excel. We only have 1,048,576. So the solution's gonna fill all of column A, B, C, D, E, F, maybe even part of G. Rather than start to type 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that, let's switch over to VBA. Now, if you've never used VBA before, you have to do this. Alt T for tools, M for macro, S for security, and change this from the top setting down to the second setting. If you don't have the developer tab, right click, customize the ribbon, turn on the developer tab. Once you have the developer tab, then we can go into Visual Basic like that, right? So you'll see in your Project Explorer, View, Project Explorer, or Control R, there is a list of all the sheets, and we're gonna say Insert Module. We'll get a new module, and then we're gonna paste the code, right? The code will be down in the YouTube description. Just copy it and paste it, right? So let's talk about this. This is called List Them All. This column, we're gonna start in column one, we're gonna start in row one, and just have a counter to count how many we have. As soon as we get to row 1,048,576, we want to move to the next column. So max rows in the spreadsheet is rows.count. Oh my God, don't try this. If you're back in Excel 2003 with only 65,536, I guess it would work. To speed things up, turn off screen updating. And we know that the first digit, if the digits are arranged in sequence, can't be higher than 39, because 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44 would be the very last number. So for the first number chosen, it's gonna be from 1 to 39. For A equals 1 to 39. And then for B, it's gonna be one number higher than whatever A is. So the first time through, A is gonna be 1, and we're gonna run from 2 to 40. But eventually, you know, A is gonna be 27, and we're gonna run from 28 to 40. It'll be easier there. For C equals 1 plus B to 41, D is C plus 1 to 42, E, D plus 1 to 43, F, E plus 1 to 44. All right, this row in this column, the first time through, cells 1 comma 1 is going to be equal to, we're gonna concatenate together right here, whatever A is with a dash, B dash, C dash, all the way on out to F, no dash after F. Counter equals counter plus 1. Now, this takes some time, right? On one computer here, it took about an hour to generate all of these, and I'm not gonna make you watch that, but it's very tedious to not know if it's working or not, or if it's hung up. So every 25,000 or so, counter equals counter plus one, if the counter divided by 25,000, if that remainder is equal to zero, then save the workbook. And then I can look in Windows Explorer and see that it's counting up, counting up, counting up. Add one to the row. If the row becomes equal to max rows, then set the row back to one, and this column equals this column plus one, and end if there, and then it just goes backwards. Next, F, E, D, C, B, A. Now, I don't want this whole thing to run, but let's just get to the first 25,000. That'll give us a great indication of what's going on. So we have a macro called list them all. I will close that VBA window and close that. And then here, list of macros, we find list them all and click run. Now, that was fast. That's really encouraging. The first 25,000 happened that fast. Let's switch back to Excel and we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Let's see how far we got in the first 25,000. We're up to 1, 2, 5, 13, 25, 30. All right, so that's good. That means that we can just turn off this breakpoint and let the thing run. But as I mentioned, it's going to take over an hour for the whole thing to run. Luckily, I've already run it, just to see if it would work. All right, here's the one that finished. So we have A1 to A104,8575. If I choose all of these cells, including column G, and we look down here, the count 7,059,052, which I think is pretty much what I predicted. So there are all the lottery combinations. Now, I know lotteries are different depending on where you are. For example, the Powerball in 2021, five balls from 1 to 69. So there's the first five loops from 69 back to 65. And then the Powerball can be from 1 to 26. It's a different color ball, the red ball. So from, you know, that's how that you would code up the Powerball. You can adapt this for just about any lottery system. Well, hey, if you want to learn about macros, check out the book that Tracy and I wrote, Excel 2016 VBA and Macros. There's actually a 2019 version and soon a 2021 version. They're all pretty much the same. Not a lot has changed in VBA over the years. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the YouTube comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank Reid for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Hit it, Nancy.